Another press conference about the financial crisis, with sub-zero temperatures to match the icy economic climate. In the Chancellery, the coalition has been holding talks about how best to react. It's a difficult situation. 2009 is an election year in Germany, and all parties concerned want to impress their voters, but also reach an agreement.
We all have the same goal. We want to help people in this difficult situation caused by the financial and economic crisis.
We are all duty-bound to compromise. The public expects the politicians to do something.
All the public knows so far is the politicians are planning a 50 billion euro stimulus package to run for the next 2 years. The coalition has promised it will have more concrete details for the electorate by next week.
People expect the German government to react, but not to overreact. They expect that it will spend or invest money where necessary, but in a sustainable manner, so that it doesn't just have short-term benefits. German citizens are really quite sensible in that respect. They're thinking of the future.
But this is an insight the coalition partners are not embracing wholeheartedly. The CDU's Bavarian sister party, the CSU, has been pushing for weeks to get one of the most popular election promises included in the stimulus package.
I think tax relief is something that the public expects.
It's not about winners or losers, it's about pushing through the right thing.
But the right thing for whom? The CSU knows that tax cuts are especially popular with conservative voters, and the party wants to be seen as their forceful advocate.
Once more, we have proved we are a lot more influential than our political opponents would like.
This remark, of course, is aimed at the SPD. The Social Democrats' proposals are tailored to please their voters. Social justice and redistribution of wealth are buzzwords likely to strike a chord with the rank and file. Tax cuts for all, including the rich, aren't likely to go down well.
There are a lot of ordinary people out there who are worried about losing their jobs or who work short hours and have less money. We can therefore assume that it's acceptable for people who are really top earners to pay more tax over the next 2 years.
Most Germans aren't impressed by the politicians currying favor with their supporters at the expense of other taxpayers. So what do these Bundestag visitors from Recklinghausen think?
I think some kind of stimulus is good.
Ask the people with small children. Who will pay the bill in 20 or 30 years? Who will pay for it all?
It sounds to me a bit like a musical request program. Everyone is shouting out, me, me, I need a few million. That's why I'd be very careful with the new economic recovery package.
These voters are the constituents of CDU politician Philipp Missfelder, and he'd like to overcome their skepticism. The Member of Parliament for Recklinghausen is sure that anyone who performs well during these times of crisis will be rewarded with votes at the next election.
The elections are just around the corner. Many considerations are shaped by the idea, what can we offer the voters that is particularly attractive?
In the Chancellery, it's business as usual, on the surface at least. Angela Merkel is carrying out her seasonal engagements, but rising above the fray is also another way of electioneering. By not becoming publicly embroiled in the cut and thrust of politics, she has more credibility as a crisis manager.
There's a broad consensus on many issues. A few points remain, but we agree on the general aim, and that's to protect jobs and make Germany fit for the future. And that's why we'll weather the crisis with the help of many social groups. I'm optimistic that Germany will emerge from this crisis with renewed vigor.
But the crisis is far from over. In just a few days, the government presents its proposals to Parliament. And despite these public demonstrations of unity, the majority of Germans are skeptical about whether this second economic recovery package will really help to beat the recession, or whether it's just intended to woo voters.